In this question, we are going to calculate the work that we need in order to pump all the water in this tank, which looks like a bucket. Throw this thing on the top of it. So, for work, we have to look at the force times distance formula, and for the force, it's pretty much just the weight. And to figure out the weight, we first have to look at the volume, and then we multiply that by the density. The density, it depends on the units that we're using. Because notice that we are using feet right here, we're using the US unit, so we have to look at the weight density of the water, which is going to be 62.5 pounds per cubic feet. But then we can worry about that later. The volume, usually it's the hardest part, so let's do it. And for the volume, we first look at horizontal slice, and we are going to consider the volume of this slice based on the labeling. This slice, as you can see, it's pretty much in the shape of a disc, and just like a CD, right? So it's circular, and it has a small thickness. And I'm going to label the radius as x, and then the vertical distance, which is the thickness, dy. And here, as you can see, if I was going to draw the slice up here, that slice would be bigger than this slice. And if I draw the slice down here, that would be a smaller slice. So it all changes. We have to figure out a formula for the volume of this slice. It changes because the radius changes. And now the question is, how can we write a formula for the radius? And then we can just do pi r squared times the thickness, and we can figure out the volume. Let's figure out what's x. And to do that, we're going to look at the big picture, the front part. As you can see, we have a trapezoid. So I'm going to reduplicate that right here. And then this is the slice, but if you look at it from the front, this is like that. This is meant to be a trapezoid. Okay, like this. Okay, and right in the middle, from here to here, I call that to be x, which is for the radius, and this right here is the dy. And now, I'm going to do this with a reference frame, right in the middle down here. And I'm going to place this right here as my x-axis, and this right here will be my y-axis. And we just need the x, not 2x, because the x is the radius of this disk, and we just need pi r squared times thickness. That will give us the volume of the disk. Okay, this is not rectangle, so we don't need 2x. And now, how can we write x in terms of y? Well, this right here, as you can see, this is a line. What we can do is, we can figure out an equation of this line. And I want to refer back to the other numbers that we know. This right here, down here is 3 feet. Let me just put down 3 for this distance here, from here to here, based on this right here. Okay? And up here is 6. That means from here to here is 6. And then this is 8 feet. So that means this right here, let me just put it on here. This right here, it's 8. So that's the information that we have. In another word, this point, based on the units, based on the measurement that we have, it must be 3, 0. And this point will be what? Well, we move to the right 6 times, and we go up 8 times. From the origin, right? So we go to the right 6 times and we go up 8 times. That means this point must be 6, 8. Whenever we have 2 points, we can write an equation of a line. And we need the slope first. So let's calculate the slope. The slope is y2 minus y1, so I'll just do it 8 minus 0 over x2 minus x1, 6 minus 3. And then we just put it down 6 minus 3. Work this out, we get 8 over 3. And I'm going to use the formula y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1. And let me just use this for the x1, y1. And the m is that. So I know that y minus y1, which is 0, it will be m, which is 8 over 3, times x minus x1, which is 3. And as we can see, y minus 0 is just y. And this is going to be, I can distribute this into the parentheses, and we get 8 over 3x. And a over 3 times negative 3 is going to be minus 8. So that's the equation of the line. But I don't want this equation of a line. I want the x, right? I want to isolate x. So we have to do more algebra right here. So we add a on both sides. Y plus 8 will be a over 3x. And then we multiply both sides by 3 over 8. 3 over 8. So that means they will all cancel out, and x will be, I can distribute the parentheses, distribute this number into the parentheses, I will get 3 over 8y plus 3. And this is pretty much x in terms of y. And that's pretty much the hardest part. Usually, we have to do the labeling and then figure out a formula. All right, so we will write an equation for the formula of this disk. Pi r squared h. So I'll write down the pi, and then just put it down here. Pi, and then the r is the x, which is that, which is 3 over 8y plus 3, and then we square that. And then we multiply by dy. So pi r squared h, right? Pi r squared times the thickness. That's for the volume. And we multiply by the density. And as I mentioned earlier, because we're using feet right here, so we multiply by 62.5. So I multiply by 62.5. That's pretty nice. And we are done with this part, and now we have to figure out the distance based on our labeling. So based on this picture, we have to ask ourselves, this is the disk. How far do we have to travel to from here to here so I can pump out this disk of water out of the tank? We have to figure out this distance. So I can look at this picture first. This picture says this distance will be y, the y value, right? And then the whole thing, we know that it was 8. With that being said, we know that this right here will be 8 minus y. So that means if this is a disk, I will have to go up 8 minus y units. And then the spot right here is just around top of it, so I don't need to add any extra distance. 8 minus y will be the distance that this disk has to travel in order to be out of the tank from here to here. And therefore, we multiply by 8 minus y for the distance. This right here represents the work that we need to pump out this disk of water, okay, out of the tank. And what we do is we are going to integrate it, all these possible disks from all the way down here, up here. As you can see, the very first disk, it will be the value when y is equal to 0. So integrate it from y is equal to 0. And the very last disk, it will be right here on top of it, which is y equals to 8. And this right here will calculate the work for you.